Alright student, kita sambung balik. Tapi saya kesian dekat Irfan ni. Asyik keluar masuk aja ni. Don't mind. Semoga urusannya dipermudahkan. Mana saya punya... Apa dia Adi? Kenapa awak? Dengar-dengar ni. Alright. Okay, so kita sambung tadi, right? So, tadi saya cakap, you kena faham apa dia function dan macam mana kita nak tentukan continuity at a function. Okay, so function ni a function. Okay, sometimes ada boleh jadi functions, right? Tapi in this case kita tengok function saja. So satu function saja. But in that function, you jangan ingat satu function tu bila kita plot dia garisan dia satu saja. Tidak, dia boleh jadi dua. Dia boleh jadi tiga. Dia boleh jadi putus-putus. Right? Dalam bahasa Melayu dia putus-putus. Dalam bahasa Inggeris dia di discontinuity. Right? So now kita nak determine if fx is continuous at a certain point. Right? At certain point. For example, in this case, dia nak tahu sama ada fx tu continuous tak? Function tu continuous tak? Di point x is equals to negative 2. X is equals to 0, X is equals to 3 in this case, right? So now student, okay, dalam case ni, bila kita tengok, okay, admit dia, okay, kita tengok, kalau you tengok dekat dalam ni, highlighter, can I use highlighter? Yes, of course I can, okay. Di kawasan negatif 2 kat sini, you akan lihat bahawa right, nampak? You dah tahu jawapan dia. Tidak discontinuity. Right, saya minggu pun dah mengaruh. Okay, so maksudnya bila you tengok macam tu, okay, you pun boleh masukkan dekat masukkan dia dalam tu. Okay, you tengok dekat dalam f, x tu, if x is equal to negative 2, so the function will be apa, berapa? Limit dia x menghampiri negative 2, dia akan dapat 1, 2, 1, negative 1 dan 1 ni, 1 ni. Which is it is, dia tidak bersambung langsung. It's not continuous. So in this case, jawapan kepada ini adalah discontinuity. Doesn't exist. Okay, the limit doesn't exist. So dia discontinuous kat situ. Dalam case yang kedua pula, if x is equal to 0. Okay, terang-terang. Yes, it is continuous. Okay, sebab dia nak tanya determine if fx is continuous or not. So yes, it is continuous. Dan case nombor 3, x is equal to 3 kat sini. Ha, ni special sikit eh. Dia macam ni dan macam ni. So, adakah dia continuous or not? Right? Jawapan dia, satu continuous, satu discontinuous. Dan kita bagi nama dia removable discontinuity. Okay, nama dia khas dia, removable discontinuity. Okay. Okay, student. Okay, moving on. Continuity of a function pun ada dia punya rules. Alright, continuity rules. If f and g are continuous at a, then the following functions are also continuous at a. Assuming c is a constant and n is greater than 0, is an integer. Integer. Okay. So now, if apa ni? A, F plus G, B, F minus G, C, C, F. Okay. Ni semua ni adalah macam rules before lah. Kalau boleh guna tak F tambah G ni? Boleh. Jika kita assume C is a constant and N ni mesti lebih besar. Boleh besar persoalan dan dia adalah integer. So boleh ke C kali dengan F? Boleh. F kali dengan G? Boleh. Okay. F divide by G provided that G tak boleh sama dengan kosong lah. Kan? Kalau tidak dia akan jadi infinity. Dan F, X dan to the power of N. Boleh. Okay. As long as N is greater than 0 dan integer. Okay. A polynomial and rational function. A polynomial function is continuous for all X. And a rational function, a function of the form P divided by Q, where P and Q are polynomials, is continuous for all X, for which QX adalah tak sama dengan kosong. Sebab kalau sama dengan kosong, again, kita tak boleh teruskan ni lah sebab dia sama dengan infinity nanti. Okay, bahagi kosong is equals to infinity. Okay, ini adalah rule dia. Alright, so there's an example here. One function. Okay, tengok, awak tengok student, focus. Tengok function dia. Fx is equals to x divide by x squared minus 7x plus 12. Betul tak saya cakap? Dalam satu function ni, dia boleh jadi macam-macam kerenah dia. So in this case, kerenah dia ada tiga garis. Ha? Kerenah lah, atau dalam English dia panggil behavior. Function behavior. Alright. Apa nama tu? Awak tengok, ada satu, ada dua, ada tiga. So maksud macam mana nak dapat ni? Awak masuk dalam software, awak plot, you get this answer. Alright. So here adalah vertical asymptote dia. Dua. Satu di kawasan, kalau saya tak salah, ini tiga, ini empat. Okay. Satu vertical asymptote dia sama dengan tiga. Satu lagi vertical asymptote dia sama dengan empat. Okay. So dia bagi tahu dalam case ni, dia continuous everywhere except x equals to 3 and x equals to 4. So x equals to 3 and x equals to 4 is the vertical asymptote for this function. Okay? Faham kan? Ha. So dalam function ni, awak boleh cerita, you can tell a story that this function, from your understanding and then from the computer that plots this function, you will get the function continuous at everywhere except x is equal to 3 and x is equal to 4. And the x is equal to 3 and x is equal to 4 is our vertical asymptotes. So ada dua asymptotes kat situ. Okay student? Saya harap faham. Alright? So continuity of composite function at a point. So if g is continuous at a and f is continuous at ga, then the composite function f, composite g is continuous at a. Okay, so continuous function with roots. Assume that m and n are positive integers with no common factors. If m is an odd integer, then fx n divided by m is continuous at all points at which f is continuous. Right? If m is even, then fx n divided by m is continuous at all points a at which f is continuous and f apa ni, FA greater than 0. Okay, ni semua macam kenapa dia bagi tahu macam ni? Sebab if M is an odd, okay, divide by contohnya apa ni, 5, 6, okay, odd integer lah, maknanya something N divide by, sorry, 5, 7, 9, okay, odd integer is continuous at all point at which F is continuous, right? If M is equals to even, right, dalam kes ni 2, 4 is continuous at all points A at which F is continuous and FA mesti lebih besar atau sama dengan kosong. So kita tengok contoh dia. Continuity at n points, right? A function F is continuous from the left or left continuous. Okay, warna left continuous is warna merah ni. Okay, warna merah ni, left continuous. Okay, at A, if limit dia as x approaching A negative, fx is equal to fa. A negative lah, kan? A negative lah ke arah sana. Okay, ke arah sana is A negative, right? And f is continuous from the right, or right continuous, yang biru ni, biru ni, okay? F, at A, if limit x approaching A positive, ke arah depan, fx is equal to fa. Okay, so ni dia bagi tahu, okay, bila C kat sini, two-sided continuity boleh happen here. Continuity from the left, okay, from the left to the right, okay, from the left to the right, and continuity from the right to the left. Continuous from the right. Oh, saya cakap terbalik kat awak ni. So yang ni yang merah, yang ni yang biru. Okay, yang ni yang merah, yang ni yang biru. Continue from the right, yang ini yang merah, dan yang ini adalah yang biru. Continuity from the left. Okay, so now. Okay, faham kan? Right? Itu contoh dia kat situ. Continuity at an interval. A function f is continuous on an interval I if it is continuous at all points of I. If I contains its endpoints, right? Continuity on I means continuous from the right or left at the endpoint. Okay. For example, in this case, okay. Dalam case ni, the function, a function is gx is equals to square root of 9 minus x squared. Okay. Nanti dia akan continuous on negative 3 dengan 3. So, right continuous at x is equals to negative 3. Okay. Dan left continuous from left to right at x equals to 3. Okay, student? The intermediate value theorem, IVT, atau kita call it IVT. Okay. Suppose f is continuous on the interval a, b and l is a number between f a and f b, then there is at least one number c in a, b satisfying f c is equals to l. Okay. So in this case, right, kalau you tengok graf ni, the function dia y is equals to fx, media dia punya ni. Okay. So the intermediate value theorem dia, L is between FA and FB. So there is at least one number C in AB satisfying FC and L. So inilah kat tengah-tengah dia. Okay. So kalau in this case of function, okay, tengah-tengah dia, dia ada C1, C2 and C3 at L. Okay. Ni untuk contoh function ini. Dan untuk function yang ketiga, fx is not continuous on a and b. Okay. A dengan b kat sini, tapi dia punya function behavior is like this. So dia tidak continuous pun. Okay. Ini maksud dia, dia tidak berada di that point. Ini maksud dia, dia berada di that point. So macam dalam contoh yang slide kita before, tiga slide before, ini adalah not continuous. Maka dia ada discontinuity. Right? Okay, so ada satu soalan exercise yang kita boleh buat bersama-sama student, right? Determine where the function below is not continuous. Dan yang kedua, evaluate the following limit. Dan yang ketiga, show that px is equals to 2x cubed minus 5x squared minus 10x plus 5 has a root somewhere in the interval of negative 1, 2. Okay, so nombor tiga tu kita kena guna the IVT theorem, which is yang ni. Okay, macam mana nak buat ni, kejap lagi saya tunjuk. So the first one, determine where the function below is not continuous. Awak ada kertas dekat sebelah dengan ada pen. Okay, cuba awak buat kejap. Saya ada jawapan dekat sini. Cuba awak buat sekejap, boleh tak? Boleh lah, saya berehat daripada bercakap seorang-seorang. Sakit ni, buat tekak ni rupanya. Bila-bila seorang-seorang. Okay, student, jangan duduk termenung-termenung atau tertidur atau tekan-tekan game. Ambil kertas dengan pen, tulis kat sini. Tulis soalan ni sebab nanti saya akan buka black whiteboard dan kita akan share jawapan dekat situ. Please student, tolong. Kalau awak tak nak tulis pun awak snapshot lah.